Welcome to Weld.com. A while back we did a video just of a comparison of two gasless flux core wires. Woo, was that ever fun on the comment section. That was, that got kind of wild. So we're going to do it again. We told you we would do it again. Everybody was curious about depth of fusion, and we want to do this time we're doing a fillet weld. Last time we just did an outside corner joint just to see how they ran. I think we had an issue of some wire that was kind of pulsing a little bit, and I believe we've got that worked out. So anyway, I want to do these fillet welds. I've cleaned some 3/16 plate up, and we're going to change values a little bit than from what we ran before. We're going to be running 20 volts, 230 inches a minute on our wire feed speed, 030 E71TGS, gasless flux core wire, straight polarity. That was the deal that we got into. A lot of people forget to change that. I'm going to go ahead and admit to you that I ran some of it for my students just to demonstrate it. And then I came back out and we were going to do another demonstration. And the demonstration was 023 wire on a 2-inch pipe on a rollout. And I'm setting that machine up that we'd had that gasless flux core and we had the polarity switched on it. Guess what I did? I couldn't figure out why this machine wouldn't run hard wire. It looked like and sounded like I had stainless and helium gas in there, and then it dawned on me. Go ahead and change the polarity back to electrode positive for hard wire. So, hey, stuff happens, you know. And we were setting this up a while ago and I couldn't get an arc. I couldn't figure out why, and you know, it helps if you have a ground clamp. You know, for 40 years I've been trying to weld without this ground clamp and it's never worked yet, so I'm learning yet. Anyway, we're going to go ahead and do this weld here. Again, we're going to, to be fair, we're comparing two wires. I'm going to try to keep things consistent. I'm not going to do much of a whip or the weave type thing. I'm just going to try to run it in here straight. I may do just a stitch and a pause, or a step and a pause, as you'd call it. It's going to be very subtle. I want to run these the same and consistent. I've even ground these plates. Notice this is kind of rusty, but I have cleaned things up, and I even have all my grind marks running the same. So just, you know, if we eliminated everything, we'd had polished and sandblasted coupons, and we'd be running this mechanically with the exact travel speed. I'm telling you, it's not going to make that much of a difference for depth of fusion off either one of them. So let's experiment. Let me get my gear on. We'll come back and run these welds. We'll go off camera. I'll cut. I'm going to sand my cut marks out of my tees that I cut out of here. I'm probably going to lick them with the die grinder on a real fine buffing pad. We're going to use some navel jelly for a etch compound so we can see a grain structure. Let me get my safety glasses on. I'll be right back. We'll have some fun. So again, I'm trying to just move down through here without a lot of oscillation or anything. For those of you that didn't watch the first part of this, one of the comments was, how come you're running a nozzle on your gun? It's the only way I can keep the contact tip attached to this particular gun. The nozzle serves no purpose other than the insulator. Here's our first side. I am going to go ahead and run the second side. I'm trying to keep my wire in here fairly straight. Well, I got hung up there, but no worries. We got a little bit of a pulse going on, not bad. We're going to run this second weld. The first one we ran the Lincoln MP211. The second weld is the Harbor Freight wire. So again, I'm going to try to keep same electrical stick out, same travel speed, same everything, just to be consistent. And then we're going to cut, etch a couple of them, and see what we're looking at for depth of fusion. Personally, I don't think there's going to be a whole lot. There may be some. You know, the difference in the wires themselves, if we were doing small projects and fitting some stuff up around the house and running off even 110 volt off some of these machines here, you know, still great wired, inexpensive, running no gas. It's all cool. So let me pull the trigger here. Hey, let's have a little fun. Side one and side one, Lincoln MP211. Both of the wires are the same. They're the E71TGS wires, gasless flux core wires, straight polarity. Ran them both on the same values. The first side, since the plates were not preheated, and I welded one side, turned it around, immediately welded the other, treated them both the same. I got a little variation in the size of my weld, okay? Decent profile, a little less spatter this time. The Harbor Freight on the first side, I've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 indications of porosity. Again, you know, I tried to keep everything the same and keep the same electrical stick out. So, you know, things happen, whether that's critical or not. Turn these around, side two, you will notice that because of the preheat of welding one and turning it around, immediately welding the other one, both of them look pretty much the same. You know, I think I noticed while I was welding that this one was a little more active and created a little more smoke and fume. Again, I wasn't worried about that. I'm looking at my weld pool trying to keep things consistent. So, you know, the next big question everybody's asking is what's the depth of penetration? What's the etch look like? So let me cut a couple of samples. I think what do you want me to do? Cut two of them out each, do two surfaces, and I'll cut and etch with some navel jelly. Be back after a while. Welcome back. This concludes our test that we ran on a comparison of two gasless flux core wires. I know that in the first video, I wasn't being a smart aleck or anything, and I said, take your pick. And I remember the weld, it was an outside corner joint wire, kind of did the same thing on both of them. I thought they ran pretty close to the same. This, to me, turned out different joint configuration, slightly higher values, but drastically different results. This time I am going to pick a wire, you know, so, and here's what happened. Here's what we noticed. While I was welding this, you know, I'm looking at the size of the bead. I welded side one and side two, they both kind of did similar things. A little cold on the first one because the plates were cold. And on the second side, because of the latent heat, I just turned them around and I welded the other one. Noticeable difference if you look close enough. The second weld flattened out a little bit, okay? And the whole deal here is people are asking about depth of fusion. They want to see this etch. Couple of things to note. The Lincoln wire, I mean, the way I have them set in front of me, I'm not picking anything yet. I'm trying to remain neutral, obviously. Good mechanical depth of fusion into the throat of the weld. If I scribe some lines down the surface of these plates, you can see that it got into the throat, theoretical throat of the weld. Okay. This one is clean. This one, way down deep, has a little bitty tiny dot. I'm not sure if that's porosity or not, but again, it's still beyond penetrating both plates. Okay. Let's go over here to this set of coupons, and I have porosity way out into the face of, just below the face of this fillet weld. We know that's undesirable. I do have some depth of fusion that looks fairly similar. Although I don't think this one looks to be penetrated as much. This one over here, again, the first weld showed porosity. It looks like about a 32nd, just shy of a 16th, below the face of the weld. This one over here is clean, although I see just a minor speck in the toe, okay? So here's the deal, you know. Again, I'm gonna say that I wasn't picking a wire on the first one. I'm picking a wire this time and I'm going with the Lincoln. I think it's cleaner. I thought it welded a little more consistently. I noticed that the Harbor Freight wire jumped around a little bit more on me. Because this is so active and got a lot of spark and fume and everything, I can't really see this porosity. If we were on a spray weld or something on a gas metal arc weld, we'd probably pick that up while we're welding it, but I wasn't able to pick that up. Also, I remember this being, I thought it put out a little bit more fume. The Harbor Freight wire put out a little bit more fume while I was welding it. Again, that's not something I'm trying to watch. I just kind of noticed it in my peripheral. But the etch is always shows depth of fusion, and I treated these the same. I gotta mention that. When I sanded these, I took them off the saw. I've left all this as a saw cut up here. I treated them all the same. I came in with a flapper wheel, an 80 grit flapper wheel. I got rid of the saw marks. I went to a die grinder and did a medium grit on a die grinder, and I changed to a fine, and I kept all of my strokes going the same direction. So I kept everything the same. I tried to get the same pressure and everything. Again, it's just a simple etch. So, you know, let's review. You know, I know that this got a lot of reviews the first time we did it, and it got into some rank comments by a couple of viewers that were unnecessary. So let's try to keep it clean this time. I'm picking the Lincoln wire simply because of the porosity. You know, are both of them prone to porosity? Yeah, because it's a gasless. Is the Harbor Freight always gonna have porosity? I doubt it. It just happened on this particular test. We could do this 6 or 7 more times. You know, and the results may flip-flop. You run into sections of wire that may run super smooth and some that just kind of poop out and don't run that great. So, I came in, and to stay consistent, I cut an inch in or thereabouts. eyeballed it, but, you know, there it is. So, have a little fun with it. I did. We appreciate your support, your positive comments. Make sure you subscribe to the videos. New videos come out every Monday. Weld.com. I'm Bob Moffitt. Thank you.